All right, church, we are on week four of our This Is Us study, and we are focusing on gifts. And I hope you are taking advantage of the study and you're not sailing it in, you're doing the reading guides, because we truly believe as a staff that each and every one of us has an opportunity to grow as we are discovering and refocusing on our six G's. So like I just said, this week is gifts week. We believe core value number four is that the church should operate as a unified body of believers, each using their own spiritual gifts and resources to spread the message of Jesus. So gifts are amazing, right? Like, gifts, they're awesome. Like, we love gifts because gifts make us feel good about ourselves. And just for like a short moment, gifts make life about us. As a kid, I mastered the art of opening the card. Like, I would open the card, allow whatever gift or gift card or check would fall out. I wouldn't pay attention to it. Don't look at it. Look at the card. Look at the card and act like you're reading the sentiments inside of it. And then, oh, Grandma, thank you so much. I didn't expect this. All right, I know that's a little sneaky, but I did that, right? All right, hey, I'm guilty of that. But somewhere along the line, I did that because my parents told me, you're not very thankful for the gift giver. Like, it doesn't look like you really care about the purpose of the gift. All you were worried about is how that gift benefits you. That's actually a very true statement, and I'm very guilty of that. However, I believe as followers of Jesus, we do the same thing with our spiritual gifts. Like, we recognize and understand that God is the gift giver. And we recognize that He has given us the gift of salvation. And for that, we are so thankful. And our lives look completely different. And we recognize that He has given us spiritual gifts. But oftentimes, as Christians, I feel like we're pretty self-centered with those gifts. We recognize that we have a gift, and we just allow it to sit. We don't do anything with it. We're not actively pursuing and using those gifts. Most of the time, we don't even recognize those gifts in our daily lives. And I think it's because we don't like how we feel about those gifts. Those gifts don't make us feel great. Because when we like how we feel about something, we actively pursue a process to use those. Like, we use the excuse all the time as Christian, I don't have time to use my gifts. I don't have the energy to use my spiritual gifts. Nobody has invited me to use my gifts. However, if we really like the way we feel about something, we will do whatever we can. We will find time. We will make energy up somehow. We will push ourselves into that process and invite ourselves into it because we can't wait to help and use those gifts. I want you to look at this. 1 Peter 4:10 says this, "As each one has received a spiritual gift, employ it in serving one another as a good steward of the manifold grace of God." God has given you a special gift. If you're a follower of Jesus, if you've accepted His grace and His salvation, He has given you a spiritual gift as well. Notice that verse doesn't say, employ the gift when you want to. It says, employ the gift. Employ it as a good stewardship of the gift giver. What does it say to Grandma if I never cash her check? What does it say to God who created you and created me and formed us with His own hands, like it says in Job 10, if we never unwrap the gifts that He has created inside of me? The Bible says that even in your mother's womb, God was molding and shaping you. God started uniquely shaping and working in you for a specific purpose. That means your spiritual gifts, your heart, your abilities, your personality, your experiences, all that is for a specific purpose. That God has a plan for you and He has put that inside of you. So my question to you is, are you living out that purpose? So that's the first thing we need to recognize as we're going through this study this week and as we're doing the reading guide. We have to stop and read the scripture and think, God, how am I going to apply Your word today? And we need to stop and recognize that we were shaped and prepared for a purpose. So that's the first thing we need to remember. We were shaped and prepared for a purpose. Not by an accident, but for a specific reason. Again, like I said earlier, your gifts, your heart, your personality, your abilities, your experiences, all that stuff is for a reason. You were called to use those things to love God and love others and draw others closer to Him. Look at Ephesians. It says in Ephesians 2:10, "For you are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do." You were created and prepared for a purpose, and you can do this. You can do this. You can make a difference in the lives of others because God has put that in you already. So again, the first thing we need to recognize as we're studying is that you were created and you were shaped for a purpose. The second thing when thinking about gifts is we need to understand that you are unique. Now, that doesn't sound like a compliment, does it? Like, I've had people say that to me several times in my life. "Matt, you're unique." Yeah, I am. I'm a unique person. I'm weird, but you're unique. Each and every one of us is unique. God created us all different with different personalities and experiences and hearts and passions and given us different spiritual gifts because we are all unique and wonderfully made and all can be used in the body of Christ. So while that doesn't sound like a compliment, it is. Because you are needed. You specifically are uniquely created and needed in the body of Christ. And if you don't use your gifts in the unique way that God created you, then things are not going to happen the way it could. Because nobody else can use your gifts like you can. And our body will suffer when you, uniquely and beautifully made, are not using your gifts. Every single person has a role in the body of Christ. The left hand can't say to the right hand that you are not needed. The hands can't say to the feet that you're inadequate and you're not needed. Your nose, your eyes, your hairs, your ear hair, all important to the body of Christ. You are unique. So remember, you were created with a purpose and shaped for a purpose, and you are unique. And lastly, this is the hardest one. Your gifts aren't for you. Your gifts aren't for you. Remember 1 Peter 4:10, it said, employ your gifts to serve one another. These spiritual gifts were not given to you for you, but they were given to you so that you can serve one another. It couldn't be any more different than any other gift you've ever received in your life. This gift isn't about you. It's about building up and edifying the body of Christ so that other people can see and experience the love and the grace of our Father. Ephesians 4:12 through 13 says this, "To prepare God's people for works of service so that the body of Christ may be built up until all reach unity in the faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God and become mature, attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ." Each and every one of us have been given a gift. However, did you notice what that said again? It says, our spiritual gifts are not about us. That's hard for us to swallow at times, right? These gifts aren't about us, but they are used to build up and edify the body of Christ. It's used to build up others and pour into other people's lives and make a difference. It's not about satisfying self, but it's about growing and maturing others in the relationship with Jesus. It's about helping your life group members see and experience Jesus. It's about helping our church be stronger than ever because you are employing the gifts that God has given you. Each and every one of us knows somebody in our lives who was sold out following after Jesus, and then they started falling away. They started following the things of the world and stopped living for Jesus, and we all hate that. Sometimes I wonder, would that have happened if the body of Christ was really using their spiritual gifts? I don't think so. Oftentimes, I know that if we were truly employing our spiritual gifts, then we would be creating an environment where people are maturing and growing and finding new life in Jesus because we are actively using the gifts that God has given us. When you use your gifts, it helps create maturity and stability in the body of Christ, all the way from babies to senior adults, you are making an impact. How great is that? To know that God has given you a gift. He's given you tools and abilities. He's created you for a purpose to help draw people closer to Him. It's just now our time to recognize the gift from the gift giver and begin employing that and using that on a daily basis as we are seeking after the Father. We truly hope that as you're doing this study, like I said earlier, you're not sailing it in. So maybe this week while you're reading the reading guide, it'd be easy for you to say, you know what, Matt, I am already using my spiritual gifts. Don't just stop there. Like, daily read. Investigate His Word. And allow God to speak to you about how you can begin using your shape in a new and a fresh way to draw others to Him. Maybe you're somebody who doesn't know your spiritual gifts yet. That's all right. We'd love to help you discover that. At each one of our campuses in the lobby, we have a spiritual gift assessment that you can take that can help you begin discovering your spiritual gifts today. This week as you're reading, remember, you were created for a purpose. You are unique. And remember that these gifts aren't about you. They're about edifying the body of Christ and helping create a mature and stable body. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for your love, your grace, and your mercy. Thank you for being the ultimate grace and gift giver. We just pray that as we go into group discussion, we don't just sail it in. We allow you to speak to our hearts. And as we're reading your word this week, you reveal to us new ways that we can apply your word and begin using the gifts that are inside of us to draw others closer to you. In your name I pray. Amen.